Hey, New Life Church. We are in this series, Big Screen, and today I want to share with you and talk about one of my favorite movies and shows of all time, and it's called Band of Brothers. This docuseries is currently available to watch on HBO Max, and I would encourage you at some point to go watch this for yourself, because what we see is an actual reenactment of a true story of how we watched the 101st Easy Company during World War II and how they go from training camp all the way through to the end of the war in Berlin. And perhaps my favorite thing about this docuseries, which is, first of all, it's incredible, and so much admiration is built from watching the men and women of our armed services and what they go through and what they deal with when it comes to war. But perhaps the thing that encouraged me the most, that I love the most about this show, is seeing the relationships built and the strength that they carry throughout not only the journey, but beyond that through the rest of their lives. And we see these men as they come together behind this similar mission of wanting to save the world and protect what is good. And they're volunteers and barely know each other and just acquaintances. And as they go through these trials and circumstances and the battles of war, what happens is by the end, you see that they've created, literally, they become a band of brothers. And you see how important and how vital this brotherhood becomes, even throughout the circumstances they're dealing with. Oftentimes, you'll see throughout the shows, without giving too many spoilers away, about how many men who would get injured will actually sacrifice the safety of being in a hospital bed and being in the comfort, and they'll come back even prematurely from their injuries just to be around one another. You see how cool it is, even in the moments when they're in the foxholes and dealing with the fear, how they're encouraging one another and rebuking the fear and replacing the doubt and leaning on one another just to engage and survive throughout the craziest circumstances that we could ever ask, think, or imagine. And really, it got me thinking about how important it is to have these relationships and have this community of people around you, even through our civilian life and through the walk and purpose that God has for us on each and every single day. And actually reminds me of this scripture in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 23. And when I watch this docuseries, I can't help but always go back to this scripture and think about what the Word of God says. It says in verse 23, Hebrews chapter 10, "Let us hold unswervingly to the hope we profess, for he who promised is faithful. And let us consider how we may spur one another on towards love and good deeds, not giving up meeting together, as some are in the habit of doing, but encouraging one another, all the more as you see the day approaching." It's so cool because we can take this scripture and apply it to what you watch throughout the band of brothers. You see how they come together behind this one mission of trying to do something good. Just like many of us, we voluntarily come to church behind the vision and mission that Jesus Christ has created in each and every one of us. And we come together for that. And then I see throughout the docuseries how they spur one another on towards love and good deeds, oftentimes relying on one each other, the encouragement, even the rebuke of fear in each and every one of their lives to survive these incredible moments. I think that's what God has provided us and our brothers and sisters in Christ, to spur each other on towards love and good deeds, to having practical outcomes to our lives through the encouragement and rebuke of our brothers and sisters in Christ. And just like these servicemen relied on one another to survive many battles and situations, we can survive on one another to survive many of the crazy circumstances that we're dealing in our lives. I don't know about you, but there are moments that feel hopeless for me. And if it wasn't for the encouragement of a brother or sister in Christ alongside of me, I don't know if my wife, my family, or even I would have survived some of these crazy circumstances. And then to think about this, not getting in the habit of not meeting together, but continuing to meet together. Like I said previously, you'll notice in many episodes that many of these men, when they were apart because they were injured in battle, they would leave prematurely because they couldn't stand the fact of being away from each other for so long, that they would rather sacrifice what is convenient or comfortable just to be in the presence of one another, because that's how much they loved and valued and cared about each other. I think about this past pandemic and some of the risks and things we had to think about of just having church together. Yet we chose to be around each other because, just like those servicemen, we understood the value of community, the value of meeting together and encouraging one another and worshiping together and just participating in life together. There is power and strength in numbers. And I think that's why the Lord gave us the church, gave us this biblical community, because it can create strength, it can create hope, it can also spur us on towards loving each other and good deeds by simply just being around each and every one of us every single day. You know, my favorite quote from the movie is actually by one of the servicemen. He says, in reflection, he says, in thinking back on the days of Easy Company, I'm treasuring my remark to a grandson who asked, Grandpa, were you a hero in the war? No, I answered, but I served in a company of heroes. It's so interesting as their relationships grew, as they went from volunteers to brothers, their admiration and respect grew for one another. And I think about as we continue along in our journey and our relationship with God and throughout our lives, as we work hard to stay unified and continue in our community together, what we'll begin to see in our lives is that our admiration and respect will grow for one another. And as a result, the relationships will grow stronger and can last a lifetime. And I think this is the way the Lord has taught us and is equipping us to love one another and to spur each other on towards love and good deeds. And why God has blessed us with the ability to have church and the ability to have a community of believers around us to help us in our lives. So I want to encourage you today that I'll be praying for you, that you have this community of believers around you. And if you don't, I want to encourage you to be more intentional with doing that, with creating some of these relationships, whether it be in church, whether it just be with family members that you know are also believers in Christ, but whatever brothers and sisters you have around you in Christ, man, to encourage them today, to love on them, because they may be in a situation themselves, or you may find yourself in a situation where you need to rely on them in your life. So let me pray for you. Father, we thank you so much for this opportunity. God, we're thankful that we have people in our lives that can encourage us, that can believe in us, and that can love us through hopeless situations. God, thank you for the brothers and sisters in Christ and the community and the bond that you've created through centering us around Jesus Christ and the foundation he's given all of us. And we thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen.